Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 4 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, I showed you how to maneuver around the sequencer so we can see all the different parts of the strips. And we finished that video by selecting a frame range and clicking this animation button to render the frame range to a video file. Now, in today's video, I'm going to continue talking about the sequencer, and we're going to talk about doing multi-selects of the different strips. We're going to show you how to grab and move the strips, and finally, we're going to show you how to cut the strips. Now, before we get started, I just want to fix the view a little bit, because it's actually a little bit off. Like, the video that we have in the preview window is underneath my webcam, and we're not seeing the total strips from end to end in the sequencer. So we can fix that using the tips that I gave you guys in the previous video, and that is, let's click on our sequencer and click the home button, and that will show us all the strips end to end. And then I showed you guys this in the previous video. You can click your mouse wheel button on the sequencer to grab the background and move it. You can do the exact same thing on your preview window. You can just click your mouse wheel button and drag this over so it's no longer underneath my webcam. Isn't that cool? Now, let's get started by talking about how we can do selections in the sequencer. Now, you can see already that our audio strip is already selected because it's highlighted. Let's unselect that. Now, if I want to group select a bunch of strips, which you'll commonly want to do because specifically with audio and video that is in sync, you want to make sure that you are moving the audio and the video together so that they stay in sync when you move them to a different frame. So it's important that we learn how to do a simple group select. And the way that you can do that is you hold your shift button down on your keyboard and you select each strip with your right mouse button. As you can see, they are both highlighted, so now they are ready to be moved. But before we move, I want to show you another way that you can select a group of strips that I only learned later in the previous tutorial series, but it's really an easy way to grab a whole bunch of little segmented strips. And that is to use the box select B button. So if we click on the sequencer to unselect, and now we go to our keyboard and we hit the B button, you'll see that it makes this crosshair. And you can now use your left mouse button and click down and drag, and whatever it drags over, it will select. That is a great way to select very, very small segments. But I actually use that over even using the shift select. It's just so easy to do. So that's two ways that you can select. Now let's talk about grabbing. Now, just like there's a B button on the keyboard to select with a box, the G button on the keyboard is the button that designates that we want to grab whatever we have selected. So we're going to grab these two that have been selected, these two strips, by hitting our G button. And now you'll notice if you move your mouse around, it will follow it. Now it's very useful to use constraints when you're selecting and grabbing. Now a constraint will allow you to pick an axis and force the move to only work on that axis. So for example, after I hit the G button, I can now hit my X button, and no matter how much I move up and down, it will only go left and right. And right now, I can just switch it to the Y axis by clicking the Y button, and no matter how much I go left and right, it will only go up and down channels. It's a very easy way to move your strips to a different channel without making them fall out of sync with the frame that you have them set on. So let's put those back, and that's the way that you actually grab. Now let's talk about doing cuts. Now, cuts are pretty straightforward. You have two types. You have something called a soft cut and something called a hard cut. And we're going to view our cuts by going down to this strip menu right here. And you'll notice right here we have our cuts. Cut soft at frame and cut hard at frame. And the shortcut key for a soft cut is K, and the shortcut key for a hard cut is Shift K. Now let me show you a soft cut first. So we're going to select a random place in our sequencer that we want to cut at, and I'm going to now hit the K button, or we can just go down here and select soft, cut soft at frame. Now it only cuts what is selected. So it did cut both of these strips, but if I only selected one, it would select one. So just make sure that you have your multi-select on when you're doing the cut. Now let's move our cut, or the backside of our cut, up a channel so that we can actually see some of the things that are left behind. So let's select with our shift button and our right mouse button. We have multi-selected our two strips. Hit our G button and hit Y to constrain it to go straight up on our Y-axis, right there. Now, there we go. So, do you notice anything that looks interesting? Well, do you see these underscores and these overscores? I guess you'd call them overscores. This is a trail that is left behind whenever you do a soft cut. And what that really means is that each of these sides of the cut contain an entire copy of the video and audio strip that they were cut from. So we actually have two copies of this exact same video and audio strip. And all that has happened is it's muted out the section that it's not using here, and it's muted out the section that this strip is not using here. And the reason why is we can use these handles to actually readjust the cut after we've made it. So we can say, you know what, I really wanted to add a couple frames, I miscut, and I don't want to undo and recut it. So the way we would do that is we would grab with our shift and right mouse button to do our multi-select, we would click on our handles. And the handles will allow us to pull frames and add frames and take them away. So I can hit my G button, which means grab, and I can now pull to the left and it will add frames, and I pull to the right and it takes frames away. So let's hit the escape button to return it. And the same is true down here, works exactly the same way. So that's how a soft cut works. Now let's just do a hard cut. So I'm going to hit CONTRL Z a couple times. That is the undo shortcut. So we'll hit it a couple times so we can restore it to the pre-cut strip. Okay, there we go. Now let's go down here and click on the strip menu, and we're going to select cut hard at frame, or you can hit Shift K to do it. And let's pull it away the same way that we did last time. We're going to right-click and hit our shift button and right-click again. And now we're going to grab it with our G button and constrain it to the Y-axis so it stays on the same frame but goes up a couple channels. And let go by clicking our left mouse button. And you'll notice there is no trail. So I think that should do it for today. I will see you guys in the next video.